Diabetes is a condition in where your body either doesn't produce enough insulin or doesn't use it effectively. And so you can think about insulin as the key. When you eat carbohydrate, your body turns that into glucose. That glucose is used for energy in your cells, and insulin is the key that unlocks the door so that the glucose can enter the cell and be used for fuel or energy for your body. When you don't have the key that opens the door, so either absolute deficiency of insulin or the keys aren't effective, you build up glucose in your system, what's called high blood sugar or hyperglycemia, and this is what is diabetes. So there's several types of diabetes. The most common two types of diabetes are type 1 diabetes, which is an autoimmune process. And this used to be called juvenile diabetes or insulin-dependent diabetes. However, we now know that type 1 diabetes can occur at any age. And in fact, in 2022, over 62% of patients diagnosed with new onset type 1 diabetes were over the age of 20. And type 1 diabetes is an autoimmune process. So normally your body produces antibodies to fight foreign substances like viruses or bacteria. But in this case, it turns against your own body and attacks the cells of the pancreas that produce insulin. So in patients with type 1 diabetes, this autoimmune process destroys the beta cells that secrete insulin, and you have an absolute deficiency of insulin. The second type of diabetes, which is more commonly known to most people, is type 2 diabetes, previously called adult onset diabetes. However, we now know that it's not just adults, and it was also termed non-insulin dependent, but many patients with type 2 diabetes end up on insulin. So type 2 diabetes is caused by a resistance to insulin. So initially you make enough insulin, but you don't use it well. So you can think about those keys that unlock the door. The keys just don't work very well. So your body produces extra insulin initially to try and overcome that resistance. Over time, however, your body doesn't produce enough insulin, and so many patients with type 2 diabetes are not just resistant to insulin, but they end up with insulin deficiency. There are also other types of diabetes. There's diabetes during pregnancy, which is gestational diabetes. There's diabetes due to what we call pancreatic injury. So if someone needed a pancreatectomy or had chronic inflammation of their pancreas called pancreatitis, they can develop insulin deficiency and diabetes. There's also cystic fibrosis related diabetes. And then there's some other genetic causes. We call it a MODY or maturity onset diabetes of the youth that are more rare causes of diabetes. So the symptoms of diabetes include feeling very thirsty, having to urinate frequently, blurred vision, fatigue, weight loss. Weight loss and something called diabetic ketoacidosis are more common in type 1 diabetes when you have an absolute lack of insulin. However, they can occur in either type of diabetes. So it depends on the type of diabetes. When we're talking about type 2 diabetes, the more common risk factors include having a family history, being overweight or obese, high blood pressure, cholesterol, smoking, having a prior history of gestational diabetes increases your risk of type 2 diabetes. And then if we're talking about type 1 diabetes, there is still a genetic component, so having a family member with type 1 diabetes, but other risk factors include having other autoimmune diseases, so having celiac disease or Hashimoto's, which is an antibody disease attacking your thyroid. We also know that for type 1 diabetes, there are environmental factors. So there's been several viruses that have been implicated in increasing the risk of type 1 diabetes. Mm-hmm. if you think about in general, diabetes or high blood sugar affects both small and large blood vessels. And so when we're talking about small blood vessels, we're talking about damage to the back of the eye, so it's a leading cause of blindness. Blood vessels that feed nerves, and so you can get something called neuropathy or numbness and tingling. And then large blood vessels, patients especially with type 2 diabetes, the risk of stroke is twice as high. And the leading cause of death in diabetes, in type 2 diabetes, is cardiovascular disease. So in general, it affects small and large blood vessels.